Today we are starting with the 28th class, and in this class we will be winding up the Science and Technology Current Affairs of April month 2020. Our first topic today is Challenge COVID-19 Competition. If you abbreviate this, this becomes CCCC3, okay? Challenge COVID-19 Competition, as the name says all. This is for the COVID-19 pandemic containment. How? The citizens will come with the innovative solutions, and one organization, one institute will be funding it, will incubating it. That institute is National Innovation Foundation. National Innovation Foundation has identified some science and technology based innovative solutions, okay, creative solutions, innovative solutions, those are science and technology based, and that will, through the challenge COVID-19 competition, this will tackle COVID-19 pandemic. What is that? See, there will be citizens coming up with the innovative solutions, and maybe researchers also, maybe school students also, maybe college students also, all of them will be invited to suggest some innovative solution to tackle the COVID-19 pandemic. Out of that, some will be selected which are really usable, really, I mean, innovative and cost effective, and those techniques will be utilized in COVID-19 pandemic containment. And incubation will be provided by National Innovation Foundation. So first of all, we need to know what is that National Innovation Foundation. So here is our National Innovation Foundation. National Innovation Foundation with India it is, okay? Here India is also taken along. So National Innovation Foundation India. This is a body of Department of Science and Technology. Department of Science and Technology is present in the Ministry of Science and Technology. Now see the nature of the body. It is an autonomous body. Here I want to clarify one thing. So many times you read that one body is autonomous, still under some department. It's okay. It can be under the department. It will be under the government. But autonomy is provided. Okay. This is not just direct executive body. Autonomy is provided to some extent. That is why some departments, some institutions are called as autonomous institutions. So National Innovation Foundation is an autonomous body of the Department of Science and Technology. It was created in 2000 and its headquarters is in Ahmedabad, Gujarat, not Delhi, not Karnataka, not Maharashtra. It is in Gujarat, Ahmedabad. Why was this body created? This body was created to support and strengthen the grassroots technological innovations. Here see, in COVID-19 pandemic also, it is demanding some grassroots from the general population innovative technological solutions which can help fight the country COVID-19 situation, and some outstanding traditional knowledge also will be supported. Till now, see, it has a pooled database of over 315,000 technological ideas, innovation and traditional knowledge practices in India from over 608 districts of the country. So headquarters is in Gujarat, Ahmedabad, but the innovations are coming whole through the country. 608 districts, more than 3 lakh innovation technological ideas have been pooled as a database in this National Innovation Foundation. See, innovators can be grassroots innovators, school students, and it also provides some annual APJ Abdul Kalam Ignite Children Award functions. This was the nature and organization and origin of your National Innovation Foundation India, which is coming up with C3 or Challenge COVID-19 competition. So citizens will be engaged in innovative ideas so that they can come up with some creative ideas, cheap ideas, and these innovation will help to manage pandemic situation and its consequences in the future. Under the campaign, incubation will be provided. Incubation means in the initial stage, and innovation needs incubation, right? Funding, research and development, value addition, mentoring. So everything will be provided by this institution, and value addition will also be provided by this institution. For example, if you take the example of some foot operated device for hand sanitization, that can be used by the people who are not able to use their hands, I mean the Divyangs people. They can use the foot operated device for hand sanitization. Some innovative sprayer has come. These two things have been recently supported by this National Innovation Foundation India under this campaign. Just an example. Second topic is also related to innovation only for the COVID-19 pandemic. Hack the Crisis India. This is the name, okay? This is an initiative by the Ministry of Human Resource and Development. Why Minister of State? Because the announcement was done by Minister of State, but the ministry responsible is HRD Ministry, now known as Education Ministry after the National Education Policy. See, this news came in PIB. It came in April. Aim of this hackathon is to strengthen fight against COVID-19. Hackathon is what? The ethical hacking people will gather together and find innovative solutions to this COVID-19. This is not confined to our country only. Fine, the Human Resource Development, HRD Ministry or Education Ministry is organizing this Hack the Crisis India. But this Hack the Crisis India is part of a global initiative. This hackathon is part of a global initiative. And in India, it is being organized by Hack Across India. And also collaboration with FICCI, FICCI, Ladies Organization Pune. This is industry body, okay, FICCI. And supported by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology. So how many ministries involved now? HRD Ministry has announced this. So we are coming up with the Hack the Crisis, because this hackathon and everything is related to education. So Hack the Crisis is coming by HRD Ministry, but supported by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, because this is a hackathon related to your ethical hacking and everything. And the organizations related are, one is your industry body FICCI, Ladies Organization, Pune Centered, and one is Hack Across India. Don't you want to know about this Hack Across India? What is that? FICCI everyone knows, ministry everyone knows. But what is Hack Across India? Here it is. It is their official website. You see, online hackathon, Hack the Crisis India, recently started by them, Hack the Crisis India. Hack Across, this thing was created with an idea of create while you isolate in quarantine times of COVID-19 crisis. Online hackathon, okay, this is online hackathon, Hack the Crisis India, working with intent to develop solutions to deal with the special focus on containment of coronavirus. So almost 15,000 people came together and now they created this hackathon, and people will be submitting online solutions and they will be working on it, and the innovative solutions will be coming on the ground. The winning ideas from few top participant teams will be implemented on the ground in the corona crisis, and it is expected to help India and global citizens contain this pandemic. Over 2000 teams, 15,000 participants, as I told you, came together. They will be enhancing the working prototype in 48-hour hackathon. Okay, this was for 2 days, 48-hour hackathon. This is actually not related to ethical hacking and all. The name is only the Hack the Crisis. This is related to finding the innovative solutions only. But as online submission is everything happening, so they are calling it a hackathon. Now during COVID pandemic, the testing techniques are too much in news, okay? Because every state wants to test so many people, but the resources are less. Some testing techniques take time, some are very costly. So every state, even union government, is looking for some cheap and fast testing technique. So we will try to study some testing technique. So topic is transmission testing and prevention methods for COVID-19 pandemic. First one is the most interesting, and recently Bihar has been giving so many test result in 10 minutes because of this test only. The test is named as Feluda test, okay, not Feluda, okay, Feluda test. Why? I will tell you why. In Satyajit Ray's novels, stories, books, in some movies also maybe, there is one character. That character is detective by nature, okay? Investigator. And that character is very intelligent, just like your James Bond, and gives the result in 10 to 15 minutes. So that is why this test is known as Feluda test. That means this Feluda test will be giving the results in just 1 hour, and this is a very intelligent test. And why Feluda test was named? Because the researchers who identified it were Delhi-based some researchers who were Bengali, okay? So they said that this is a tribute to Satyajit Ray, because next year, that means 2021, it will be the centenary of Satyajit Ray. Who was Satyajit Ray? He was the India's, you can say, the greatest filmmaker, author and illustrator. And his movie only, the first movie in 1955 was Satyajit Ray was Pather Panchali. That movie went to win so many awards internationally, that is just still remembered, the Pather Panchali. So Feluda was the character created by Satyajit Ray in his novels and books, and Feluda was an investigator, okay? So in that investigator's name only, the fictional character's name only, the scientists have come with the Feluda test. This will be like a strip, okay? One strip, just like pregnancy strip. You drop a sample here and the color code will change and the results will come. And now Bihar is giving test result in 10 to 15 minutes because of this. This looks like this. So here you drop the sample and the color will change. If both color changes, that means there is CIG. What is that? Immunoglobulin. Your antibodies are activated, that means virus is present in the body. If the color does not change, that means virus is not present. Very simple testing technique, very cheap and very fast. See the name 2019 and novel coronavirus nCoV. Okay, so this is Falooda test and the story behind it. But we will see the news. Council of Scientific and Industrial Researchers Research. You have CSIR, right? Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Under the CSIR, there is one Institute of Genomics and Integrative Biology. It is based in Delhi. CSIR IGIB is based in Delhi. That institute has developed India's first paper strip test for COVID-19, and the test is known as Falooda. If you know the name of the scientist, you don't want to remember that, but if you know the name of the scientist, you will understand why this is named as Falooda after Satyajit Ray's character. See, a team led by Dr. Souvik Maiti and Dr. Debjyoti Chakrabarty in CSIR's Institute Genomics and Integrative Biology, CSIR IGIB New Delhi, have developed a test for detecting coronavirus in people, and this is India's first paper-based test for detecting coronavirus in people. Just like pregnancy test, very simple, easy to use, available for everyone. Not everyone, maybe you can also test, but it is the responsibility of government, so they will be doing the testing, but it is very fast. So if somebody asks that how much time it takes, so a standard time taken by this paper strip test is 1 hour, okay? And Falooda is also an acronym based on the character of Falooda, fine. But Falooda is also an acronym. Acronym of what? FNCAS9 Editor Linked Uniform Detection. You don't need to remember that, okay? FNCAS9 Editor Linked Uniform Detection, you don't need to remember. You should just know that Falooda test is for COVID-19 pandemic testing, and this is a paper strip based test. It is expected to help fulfill an urgent need of the rapid testing. Urgent need is required, particularly in the states which can't afford too much. It is the first such indigenous test kit to be developed in India based on clustered, regularly interspaced, short palindromic repeats technology. The CRISPR technology is present behind this test, okay? Clustered, regularly interspaced, short palindromic repeats. CRISPR technology is behind this testing. For UPSC, this CRISPR technology is also very important. So now I will be explaining you the CRISPR technology also here only. I will explain you this CRISPR technology very easily in a very lucid language. See, the whole thing is CRISPR-Cas9 technology, not CRISPR technology. The whole thing is known as CRISPR-Cas9 technology. First of all, you should know that this technology, this technique is borrowed from natural world. This technique is shown by bacteria. When a virus attacks bacteria, the bacteria's defense mechanism is Cas9 technology. We are borrowing this technology or duplicating this technology artificially in the human world. That is CRISPR-Cas9 technology. First of all, this is a gene editing technology. Okay, gene editing technology regularly used by bacteria to fight virus attacks. And now understand how does it work. These are proteins, okay? This Cas9 is protein. So Cas9 is protein, fine. But what about CRISPR? What is the role of CRISPR and what is the role of Cas9? This is a cut-paste mechanism. How? Suppose take a random person, okay? That random person has some problem in genetic code and the wrong information is present or the bad information is present, and that may be causing a disease or that may be causing deficiency of any protein or something, biomolecule deficiency. So first of all, that genetic code needs to be identified. The location needs to be fixed. This CRISPR part will identify the location that here, see, in this genetic code there is a problem. Okay. Now what will happen? It is the body's tendency or defense mechanism that if a genetic code, somehow if we delete them, the body will repair, okay? Body will replace it. So first of all, CRISPR identifies the problematic genetic code, and now the Cas9 protein goes on the identified location and it works like a pair of scissors, and this location, this wrong genetic code, is cut off from the regular strand. So if you visualize, suppose this is DNA strand, okay, DNA strand, and here is the problem in genetic code. So we now need to remove this. But first of all, how we identify that here is the problem? For that you have CRISPR. CRISPR will identify this, okay. Once identified and fixed, now Cas9 will come and it will cut it, okay. Now just when it is cut, the body's repair mechanism will adjust and make a fresh copy or maybe repair, and this cut part will be removed and it will be regular normal strand. That is why we say that a DNA strand, when broken or cut, that has a natural tendency to repair itself. Atmanirbhar DNA, okay. Scientists do what? Scientists will intervene in this auto repairing process, and they will supply the body with desired sequence of genetic codes that will bind here, and the new DNA strand which is repaired will be having the desired genetic code supplied from the scientist or researchers, okay, and it will be joined with the broken DNA strands. So first of all, wrong genetic code removed, and good genetic code or utility having genetic code is inserted by the scientist. This is CRISPR-Cas9 technology. Your Feluda test for this testing purposes works on this CRISPR-Cas9 technology. This is a testing purpose only, okay. This is not some remedy or something here, but the technology behind was CRISPR-Cas9, and in general you needed to understand what is CRISPR-Cas9. That is why I have explained here, but this mechanism is not directly related to your testing purpose only. This is for repair and everything, but this testing thing also in the background, this CRISPR-Cas9 thing is happening. So just understand these things. Our next topic is vertically transmitted infection. Okay, fine, infection is being transmitted and all, but what is vertical transmission? Vertical transmission here means a progeny, a child of someone, getting the COVID-19 from their mother. Vertical transmission, okay. What is horizontal transmission? I giving you COVID-19 or you giving me COVID-19 is horizontal transmission. But some child getting COVID-19 infection from the mother during the childbirth, that is vertical transmission, because happening in one genealogy. Vertical transmission refers to the transmission of an infection from a pregnant woman to her child, and scientists are suggesting, because of recent emerging evidences, that in COVID-19 disease, this vertical transmission of infection is possible. Okay, it can be antenatal. Antenatal means anti means before, natal means birth. This can be antenatal, that is before birth also. Perinatal, that means around the birth, weeks immediately prior to or after the birth, or postnatal also, after the birth if the mother is beside the child, that will be the postnatal. During the delivery if it happens, or just weeks immediately to the delivery, or just after the birth if it happens, it is called perinatal. And during the pregnancy itself, gestation period itself, if the infection happens, that is called antenatal vertical transmission of the disease. Transmission might occur across the placenta, that will be during the gestation period, in the breast milk, that will be after the childbirth, that is postnatal, or through direct contact during or after birth. Among infections of which vertical transmission has been known, other diseases, HIV, you know already, some mother having HIV, child is almost expected to have the HIV. This Zika virus in South America, it was found that, okay, in Zika virus also the transmission can happen by mother to child. Rubella virus here also, and your herpes virus. All these four viruses have been known to cause vertical transmission of the disease. So for that, what happens? If the scientists are suggesting this evidence that can be vertical transmission of the disease, so janta, the people, need to be aware. For that, Indian Council of Medical Research has issued awareness guidance for management of pregnant women in COVID-19 pandemic. Nobody can stop the pregnancy for which the conception happened before COVID, and also the population will not stop at a time. So there must be some guidance for management of pregnant women who are having COVID-19 positive women. If they are having the pregnancy, it is expected that the child will also be infected. So for that, Indian Council of Medical Research has issued some guidelines. See, these are the precautions, these are the things you can do so that the child does not get the infection. Now be very ready. We are going to see some innovation, some technologies developed by Indian organization, Indian companies and people also, which are being utilized in COVID-19 pandemic at a larger scale or a smaller scale, but all of these are innovations which are workable and which are having the utility. First is by your Defense Research and Development Laboratory. This Defense Research and Development Laboratory has developed a kiosk, okay? The kiosk is very special. Kiosk is known as COVASAC, and this is abbreviation, full form is COVID Sample Collection Kiosk. COVID Sample SA Collection and Kiosk. What is special about it? This kiosk is automatically disinfected without the need of human intervention or involvement. That will make the process free of infection or spread. Okay, so healthcare workers will not be affected. So that means this kiosk is for healthcare workers, but they are directly not involved. This is automatically disinfecting. Healthcare workers will only be putting the samples, okay, collecting the samples and putting over here. Sample collection is also a very infectious stage. In that stage, this kiosk will be used, and it is self-cleaning or automatically disinfecting one. So it will collect the COVID-19 samples from the suspected infected patient, and it will be automatically disinfected so that the healthcare personnel and the people collecting the samples are not infected. This is developed by DRDL, I told you, Defense Research and Development Laboratory, but in consultation with the doctors of which organization? Employees State Insurance Corporation, Hyderabad. Okay, ESIC, Employees State Insurance Corporation, Hyderabad, in collaboration with DRDL, or you can say the DRDL developed the DRDL is the main agency, and consultation is done with the some doctors. Which doctors? Doctors of Employee State Insurance Corporation, Hyderabad. It has a shielding screen, okay, that cabin protects the healthcare worker from the aerosol or droplet coming from the infected person or infected sample. This is how it looks. See the cabin. This is self-cleaning or self-automatically disinfecting one. This is how your kiosk looks. COVASAC, developed by DRDL and Employee State Insurance Corporation doctors. Second one is a concept. Concept is pool testing. Suppose, before explaining you this thing, I will explain you with an example, okay? Suppose there is an area in a colony, and there was no case of COVID positive patient in that area, but still we want to check. Maybe there can be some asymptomatic patient, maybe someone might be infected and they are hiding it. So we will go in that area of the colony, and we will just pick up 5 people, okay, maximum 5 people allowed. 5 people samples will be picked up, they will be mixed together, and only one testing will be done, because it is expected that none of them will be infected. We just want to be assured of it. We just want to be sure that none of them is infected. So 5 people sample will be collected, tested together, combined. For example, see, one sample, total 5 sample mixed together, and this will be tested. If the result is negative, move on to the other 5 people. Okay, one testing only, the cheap one and the quick one, very fine. Five people sample tested together, right? So we came to know that no one was infected, very happily. We will go to another 5 people. What will happen if this is found positive? Then we will pick the five samples separately and do the testing. So this is somehow that if you are lucky, if the infection is actually not present, you will get the result very fast at very cheap cost also, because one test for the 5 people. So for your community testing, because now the coronavirus is obviously community spread. So for that, Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR has advised the feasibility of, it has been talking that we can go for the pooled sample testing also, okay? Because there has been a rise in cases in India, so we need to test the samples very fast. So just go for the pooled testing. If we find someone positive, we will go for the individual testing, so pooled testing. A pool testing algorithm involves the polymerase chain reaction, PCR testing only, not normal RT-PCR testing only, but here the specimen samples are pooled together, okay? How many? 5. Because over 5, it is not effective, okay? Pool comprising multiple individual patient specimens followed by individual testing. If there is some positive case, then they will go for the individual testing, but generally we will go for the pooling. And this is a feasibility suggested by ICMR, okay? In action, it is not very popular yet. Only if a pool screen positive, then only we will go for the individual testing. Or as all individual samples in a negative pool are regarded as negative, it results in substantial cost saving. So 5 people tested together, everyone was negative. So one testing, 5 people tested, substantial cost saving. When a large population of pool tests negative, this method is effective in two ways. First, it increases the capacity of the testing because one testing, 5 people, and also saves a lot of resources, time, cost, and manpower also. Now the question arises, why only limited to 5? Why not take 100 sample together? Maybe the whole colony is not infected, so we will save lost of time and budget. Why? Because the viral load is different. If you are mixing, suppose you have 100 samples, okay? In that 100 samples, suppose one person is COVID positive, but that person's viral load is just a few, a little bit. So that might not result in the positive testing in 100 samples. If 100 samples put together, that might not result in the positive testing, and that result may be negative. But we know that one person was infected. So that can be problematic. And what is the threshold limit? Threshold limit is not 100. Threshold limit is just 5. If after 5, if any of the person is having very low viral load, the test result might come as negative. That is why only 5. Also, obviously, this should be used only in areas with low prevalence of COVID-19, where we know the Delhi and Mumbai, the hotspot is there. So this technique will not be very useful because so many people will be tested positive. So use it in this in only those areas which are having low prevalence of low occurrence of COVID-19 disease. Only in those areas having the positivity rate of 2-5%. Or those areas where there are asymptomatic individuals. Also, if we know that some person is infected, please don't put that person's samples here, okay? Test him separately, strictly excluding pooling samples of individuals with known contact with confirmed cases. So they will check your Arogya Setu app, and if you had come in contact with someone positive for the COVID-19, your sample will not be mixed in this pooled sample. Your sample will be tested separately. Also, healthcare workers, because they are coming in direct contact with the COVID-19 patients in care system, so their samples also will not be mixed here. Only the low probability asymptomatic patients and those patients who haven't come in contact with any infected person, only samples from those people will be used here in pooling. Sample from such individuals which are coming with the confirmed case contact or healthcare personnel, those samples will be tested directly without pooling. Individual testing will be done for them. Next thing is very small topic, CarmiBot. What is that? Just first of all, see the picture of CarmiBot. This is the CarmiBot, okay? Bot helps medical staff in Kochi Hospital. How does it help? We will see that, CarmiBot. This is a robot deployed in government hospital Ernakulam, Kerala, okay? This is for serving food and medicine to the coronavirus patients so that the healthcare personnel or the nurses, the midwives, they do not come in direct contact with the person. The bot will be serving them food. The bot will be serving them medicine. That bot is known as CarmiBot, with an aim to reduce the infection for doctors and health workers. Robot is developed by what you know? The robot is developed by Asimov Robotics. And what is Asimov Robotics? That is a company working under Maker Village of Kerala Startup Mission. Okay, so there is some Kerala Startup Mission. They have developed this Asimov Robot company, and Asimov Robot has developed this CarmiBot for the hospitals and healthcare personnel of Kerala. So this is first used in Ernakulam district of Kerala. This is CarmiBot. Next topic is Acrylosorb. Okay, this is some chemical and physical body fluid collection system. Acrylosorb is the equipment to collect body fluids of patients and dispose it safely. Collection is also a problem, infection chances. Now the disposal and discarding is also a problem because that can also cause the infection. But this Acrylosorb is very important. You see the word here, sorb. This is from the absorb. Equipment itself will absorb the waste. So disposal will not happen in the open environment because equipment collecting the sample is disposing the sample by absorbing it. There is no risk of recontamination as the waste is absorbed by the equipment itself, and also it can handle more liquid waste at a time. So this is very different from the regular sample collection system. Okay, under the system, there are suction canisters which are spill proof. so spill out will not happen, and that can be sealed after use. It is used to collect liquid respiratory secretions from the patient for testing and treatment, whatever be the purpose. If you want to see how does it look, just like a plastic bag, because this is a sample collection thing. This is how it looks. See, a chilo saw sample collection. This material only will absorb it. Okay, disposable spit bag with a chilo slab. So first it is absorbed inside, then you dispose the material, and this will be sealed forever. And this is the suction canister with a chilo slab. This canister is there, okay, and inside that you have this a chilo slab disposable spit bag. This is developed by the scientist in Sri Chitra Tirunal Institute of Medical Sciences and Technology in Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Now, as I told you in the previous lecture, that many people are getting hospitalized in ICU, and artificially they need to be provided with oxygen on ventilator. So there is an alternative option for the traditional oxygen mask coming up. This is bubble helmet completely covers the head of the patient. That is their specialty, and it will be connected through a special collar on it. This device will help the patient to overcome breathing problems and avoid using ventilator facility. So you do not need to put on ventilator. There will be bubble helmet and oxygen will be provided through this. This is a little bit of improvement because it will be covering the head of the patient entirely. So how does it look? This is the bubble helmet. Okay, the patient's head will be there. He will be, see, the cushion and all resting place, and it will connect it to the collar of the patient, and oxygen will be provided through here. So this is how the bubble helmet works. Otherwise the person needs to be lying down and ventilator and everything, complex situation, right? So that's how the April month science and technology portion is finished. Next time when we meet, we will start the May month science and technology, and after that we will do the March, April, May environment. That is how our March, April, May month will end. Then only June, July, August is remaining. In August we will see till only 15th of August. So after this environment of March, April, May, we are just left with July month, complete one, and 15 to 10 days of the August month also. So that's it. Thank you.